What's up everybody, it's Smuggler Ilfi, and today I'm going to be doing a new video. You know, in my opinion, I find these interesting, talking about fights, you know, fictional characters going at it. And in this video, in episode 1, we talking about Sakura from Street Fighter vs. Videl from Dragon Ball Z. Oh man, I just see y'all, this is like, imagine this fight being real. This shit will be, it should be, you know, like, animated, and, you know, Capcom and Dragon Ball Z should come together and make this shit. Yo, but, yeah, with that being that, let's get into this. So, born in Japan, Sakura, one day, she was watching the World Warrior Tournament, and after watching Ryu win, she just became Ryu's biggest fan, you know. She trained with Dan Hibiki. If you know who Dan Hibiki is, you already know why that's a why. You know, like, Dan Hibiki, if you did not know, he sucks. He's like one of the worst trainers. But he is funny to use in the game. But let me just give it to this, yo. He did train under the, you know, training coach or master of Ryu and Ken. And eventually, of course, like, no shock, Sakura overpassed his power. And yeah, yo, that's mostly it. After that, basically making fucking Dan Hibiki's power look like it's just kids play, because let's be honest, Hideo Ken is, that's a Dan's. Sakura's, like, she would kill him in a real fight. So after training with him and passing his power, she went back to her hometown and became more like a defender of her hometown, you know. She's like, yo, I'm going to defend and, you know, protect everyone. And yeah, she could shoot out fire out of her hands like Goku and Ryu. And while she was attending school, she developed a friendly rival with Kamen Kazuki. Kazuki? Yeah. After their first fight and Kamen taking the win, man, yo, imagine that, like, you have five out of a dozen and they take the win. But after she took the win, man, she was just, Sakura just was training with Dan, having a training session with Dan over and over. So yeah, after saving Ryu with Ken, she asked to train with Ryu, you know, but he denied. He said that he is not ready to train, and you know, basically, he just did not have it within him. Basically, because what I seen, you know, in the movie and all the other stuff I played, is basically he's like, yo, dude, I can train with you. And yeah, moving on from there. They went their separate ways. You know, after having that, she developed some sort of a crush on Ryu and began searching for him. And yeah, after the second World Warrior Tournament, during the tournament, she tries to find Ryu. After finding him, she gets knocked unconscious and saved by him. Which basically is, at this point, it's basically like Amy Rose to Sonic. You know, Amy Rose gets saved by Sonic, and that leads to Addicted. Like, I love you, Sonic. You know what I mean? Basically, that's Sakura. Sakura is Amy Rose. Ryu is Sonic. So see it like that. So after finding him, she got knocked out. Boom, unconscious. Exchanges goodbyes. Ship takes the ship back home. And she does make a small appearance in Story of Kamen and Ibuki's story in Street Fighter V. But it's not that much, you know. It's basically saying like, oh, I can't make it to the party on Ibuki's side. But Kamen says she's more like, hey, I'm going to do this and that. And it does not show the results of the fight. You know what I mean? So, yeah. Moving on. Next. Videl. Shit. Born as the daughter of Mr. Satan, Videl grew up learning in martial arts, hoping one day to be as good as her father. Eventually, she did surpass him. You know, succeed to the point of overpassing him. Overpassing her father. At the age of 11, holy shit, she won the junior division of the 24th Tenkaichi Budokai? I don't fucking know. While attending school, she met her husband, Gohan, who trained Videl how to fly and did it. Yo, she only did it in fucking 10 days, dude.
Imagine learning how to fly in 10 days. That shit's fucking badass. In my opinion, that's just badass. Okay. You human, you learn how to fly in 10 days. Like, that's that's just crazy. Now, I know she didn't, she just learned how to fly. It's not like she mastered. To be honest, she, in the anime, you know, she kind of did master it here and there. She knew how to do it. So, yeah. So, I wrote down many possibilities how this shit could end, you know. So, number one, as, what the fuck, wait up. So, Sakura, she could shoot fireballs out of her hand, but she could shoot energy balls. So, depending, you know, energy versus fire, which one would win? In my opinion, you know, energy being like, you know, it's just energy now. But, yo, fire, come on. Like, in my opinion, seeing, you know, how Goku does his thing, and I know the powers aren't equal of Goku and Videl, but compare that destruction, but lower it to a point where it's just like basic, you know, as he was as a kid. So seeing those two, we could see that it is strong, the Hadouken versus the Kamehameha, you know. So it really comes down to which one is more powerful, the Kamehameha or Hadouken. And in my opinion, Hadouken, in a way of doing destruction of land, but Kamehameha doing destruction to other. Yeah, as you can see in Goku versus Majin Buu, it destroys him 100%, while other things like explosions and shit just made him go in the air, but he could repair himself. But a bigger destruction could have fucking burned him alive, and it did kill Majin Buu. For Sakura's case, in the ending of Street Fighter V, you know, the story mode shit for free, you could download on PS4 store, whatever. You know, we could see Goku, it's different, you know, not a Goku fucking Ryu, I mean, you know, it's different, you know, the Kamehameha and Hadouken in a way, because when he did it, it went through Chun-Li, hitting the other guy, you know what I mean? And she could see, like, inside it and all that shit. So, yeah. So, in my opinion, after just, like, talking about seeing each character and seeing what they could do, you know, like, Sakura, she does have her special moves, and I'll talk about the special moves right now. So, what does she do? Videl, she does, you know, more like, you know, leg throwing, and she throws her opponent and stuff like that. She could do, you know, like I said, shoot the thing out of her hand and all that. But in Sakura's case, this is how I see it. Videl, you know, Sakura, they meet, they're like, oh, shit, where, you know, of course Sakura's like, blah, blah, blah. Does that fucking, can't stand still shit. And then Videl's like, yo, I'm looking for this dude. And then they, basically, Sakura's like, I'm looking for this. And then they, you know, they fight, basically. So this is how I see it. Skip to the last paper I have here. Oh, yeah, shit, I did have it here. Good. Sakura can get Videl tricked, but causing, you know, Videl. This is how I see it 100%, okay? Wait, what? Oh, there's the paper, yeah. Dude, I thought I fucking lost it. Okay, Sakura can get Videl tricked, of course, because I'm not seeing 100% it could get tricked. It's more like Videl could eventually get Sakura tricked, because as seen in the last Street Fighter, and we didn't see her as much in Street Fighter 5. Capcom, you hearing? Your character, you're not showing that one much love. But yeah, Street Fighter 5, 4 is what I'm basing this fight on, because that's the last we see of her fighting, you know. So Sakura can get Videl tricked, but causing her to trip and fall, which gives Videl time to create a fireball holding Sakura. Videl gets Sakura and blows her head off, or chokes her to death, or stomps on her. Yeah, this shit's cool. So yeah, breaking every bone in her body until Videl has nothing else than to blow inside her. Inside, yeah. Oh, number two, how Sakura will win. Sakura can fly, making Videl. Wait, what? Not out of it. Oh, shit, yo. I mean, Videl can fly, you know, shoots her thing, misses, you know, like, what was it? Giving Sakura time to, you know, as Videl is trying to get her, you know, flying, because, you know, she could fly, not 100%, but, yo, she could go, but attacking in a way that Videl could, you know, here and there, dodge everything. Sakura, while Videl has her ready to kill, Sakura would, of course, because you know the trip and shit and all that, she basically becomes evil Sakura mode, and she just gives it all that she has, eventually trying to tire Videl. But then, well, you know, because you know what I've seen of Sakura in the evil mode is she kind of loses here and there, like motion or some shit. You know, I don't want to show it because you know YouTube and the shitty things it's on. So yeah, in my opinion, it will end with Videl taking her by the neck and giving her one on the throat or on the back. Yeah, it's kind of because Videl is strong, okay? She will most likely burn her to ashes. So Videl being badass and what I seen of her, that's how I see it's gonna go. So it's kind of in race 50-50 chances. It's basically like, you know, what is stronger, Hadouken or Kamkamaha? And besides that, that's not just it. It's just like experiences, you know. We haven't seen that much of Sakura, and the ones we saw is she getting here and there nice. As in Videl, we see her going more up. So in ways, I kind of see 50-50. So with that being that, comment below and yeah, tell me who you think will win. Next video is, of course, this is the next fight, by the way. Ibuki versus Yuffie. Two ninjas. I cannot wait, dude, to do this video. To be honest, I'm kind of more hyped to do this than, well, kind of a little bit more hyped to do Sakura and Videl than this in a way. But like, this one is just going to be amazing. Okay, stay tuned for that. With that being that, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me who you think will win of Sakura and Videl. And tell me who I should, I don't know, check out next. Till next time, bye.